Welcome back from That Short Break. Thank you very much for keeping it live with us here on Urban Television. It is Urban Today Weekend Edition, and we're getting straight into another interesting topic that has been making headlines throughout this week. Now, of course, in case you want to be part of the conversation, head over to our social media pages, Urban Television for Facebook and at Urban TV Uganda for Twitter. Previously, we're discussing the scientific way of campaigning. As far as you know, the general election 2021 is concerned. We're getting closer to it, and we're wondering, what do you think about the scientific campaign, and do you think it's going to be effective as far as yielding results is concerned? Head over to our social media pages and talk to us and let us know what you think about that particular one. Away from that, we want to talk about the bromance. You can call it the bromance, or you can call it the revival relationship between Dr. Kizza Besigye and, of course, that is Kyagulanyi, known as Bobi Wine. Now, these two also brought hands together. We understand they have been on a couple of loggerheads ever since the last time they were together. But during this pandemic, they came together and have had a campaign dubbed No Neda, whereby they are calling out fellow Ugandans who feel they are tired, hungry, and are not okay during this COVID time. So come out and get to the streets and riot, which is, of course, some of the things that has made a discussion between a couple of security organizations and individuals. As far as, you know, mass gatherings are concerned. Willis Daly, this is not the first time we're seeing coalitions happen in Uganda. We had the Kabakayeka, we had a couple of other, you know, coalitions that came through. Now, this time around in the 21st century, we are seeing Bobi Wine and, you know, that is Dr. Kizza Besigye coming to bring efforts together in order for them to lead to a common goal. First and foremost, what do you make of this coalition between, you know, Bobi Wine and Dr. Kizza Besigye?
I think the only and most successful coalition that we've had in terms of opposition is the one with Museveni and I think the Kayiras. That one was successful, and you know, they achieved their goals and they agreed and decided to move on. But the moment Ugandans decided to vote in favor of multi-party systems,
yes,
the move from the movement into multi-party systems, we may never have a coalition in the opposition. We may never have the opposition come together to say, let's front this one, because that's the purpose. Of course, some opposition leaders are saying, no, the purpose is not to get one single leader. The purpose is so that we can agree on some things and disagree on the others. You don't need to sit down in a coalition as opposition to say, well, let's agree on this one, but let's put different candidates on the forefront. But I think that, you know, it's a step in the right direction. When we see them drinking tea together, when we see them eating food together, when we see them visiting each other's homes, I think it shows a good picture. But that's just the picture. That's just for like someone who is simplistic to see that, hey, the picture has Bobi Wine and Norbert Mao, and they're shaking hands. That is simplistic. You understand? Just as simplistic as the time we saw Norbert Mao, you know, shaking hands with President Museveni.
So you don't think this coalition will work or yield the results that they want to get at the end of the day?
Well, for starters, you can't come to a coalition and the first thing you're thinking about is to tell young people to
demonstrate. Yes.
You understand? No, I don't think it's going to yield any results. I think it's going to be just like the others, the TDAs, the inter-party corporations. So that's what it's going to be.
You're
like
saying this coalition is not going to handle or stand the test of time? Given the current situation we're having in the country.
It might stand the test of time for the donors, the guys who are funding the opposition, Ugandans and people in diaspora who are putting money in the opposition. It's because it's going to be accountability. They'll ask you, Munang, what did you use our money for? And say, I tried to put the opposition together and become together and have one voice. But you know, just before we dive into the discussion really deep, I'd like to say that Bobi Wine is a very interesting guy.
Okay.
He's a sharp guy. He thinks and, you know, and put landmarks, even when the story is sort of down, he tries to bring it up and people talk about it. So I think it's a good move for him, you know, to come through and have conversations with Kizza Besigye and later, you know, have a discussion. I think it's great. Most of these opposition leaders have failed to tone down Besigye and have him in their corner. So I think it's great for him. But moving forward, I think that we need the opposition to stop this, I'd call it P7 politics, of thinking that Ugandans care about images and defiance. That we care, our politics is Kavuyo.
Mm.
Like where there is Kavuyo, we say, yes, yes, we are doing something.
Mm-hmm.
I think that is wrong. And the opposition needs to grow up. We need the opposition to sit down and tell us what they want to do when change comes.
Mm-hmm.
Because change is going to come. And the direction in which change goes is determined by who is ready to sit Ugandans down and tell them what they are going to do.
Willis, we have had a conversation to deal with, you know, the unfair distribution of food in the country during the COVID times. I mean, remember recently the Speaker of Parliament, Honorable Rebecca Kadaga, went haywire talking about the fact that, you know, some foods did not get to particular places. The quality of food that was being distributed was not good quality. And that is why Dr. Kizza Besigye, together with Kyagulanyi, are coming to join forces to make sure that they take the voices on the streets for the government to listen. I know that some of its people did not actually get this food. Is it a wrong thing to actually fight for what you deserve?
That
is what they are doing. They say they are fighting for the young man to get what he or she deserves.
The message they are sending ultimately is that whoever is in parliament, whether in the ruling party or the opposition, is doing nothing. Most of these guys in Kampala are represented by the opposition in parliament. So if you're telling people to not get their voice through their leaders to parliament, but demonstrate, you're actually saying that the guys you sent to parliament as opposition are not working. And it also ultimately means that Bobi Wine, as a member of parliament, is also overwhelmed by the work in parliament, that is not being able to make his voice heard about the issues. You understand? That's why you resort to demonstration. The Black Lives Matter is as a result of the fact that the police in the USA has failed. So that's why we say, let's demonstrate as Black Lives Matter. So what these guys are saying is that they have failed to have people in parliament raise their voice about food distribution. And that's a very dangerous place to put the political space in, or the economic space, or the food space in. So I think that the opposition, they're in every process, in every government, in every leadership, there are shortfalls. There will always be shortfalls. Let no political person, political leader tell you that, you see, when you make me president, Uganda is going to be sweet. It's going to be sweet. No, it's going to be diggy. It can't be sweet. There's always going to be shortfalls. What these guys need to do is to tell Ugandans, look, thank you very much for the 35 years in power, but here is where we want to put Uganda. Here is where we want to go. The NRM came with the purpose of bringing peace and stability.
That was, and fighting poverty as
well. They didn't come and say, these guys are these guys are that, let's demonstrate. No, they came and said, we want to bring, this is what we
So are you saying that the opposition is using the wrong approach
get
their dream or their goal home?
I think it's wrong. And I probably don't blame them. They're probably, a bit short-sighted. I think for them, they need to come and tell us, what are they bringing? Of course, we know that, you know, there's corruption, there's this, there's that. We don't have a lot of resources in the health sector. Those are negative sides of the story. Tell us the Uganda you want to see 10 years from now. Don't speak bad. You understand? Speak good. You understand? So I think that that's where the opposition is failing. Okay. That they are failing to tell us where they want to take Uganda. They are so much interested in telling us the shortfalls of the past. You know, we failed to distribute food properly and whatnot. Why don't you come and tell Ugandans that in your government, you will have this food distribution? You understand? You're busy telling us the shortfalls of this one so we can put you in power. And then what?
And then what?
Then you shock us and surprise us by doing the same.
You talked about TDA. I'm sorry to take you back, but we understand what happened to the TDA. When it got to, you know, who's going to be representing this particular group of, opposition after they had formed it, that was also another problem that led to, the decline or the declose of TDA. Now, if you're to look at some of the reasons that are coming in from this particular one, do you think that Bobi Wine, together with, Dr. Kizza Besigye, could be the right way to handle this particular one that is happening right now?
You're not going to have one person or two people holding the opposition. You have people like Ken Luchamuzi, who also want to be president. You have people like Norbert Mao, who also want to be president. I mean, the guy hasn't had this experience in politics just to come and stop there. So whenever there's a chance that presents to himself to be president, he'd like to take it. So I think that is it's not right to say that let's have one opposition face to be president or two. I think that's unfair for even me as a Ugandan. Because when I was growing up, one of the questions they asked me is, why do you want to be in the future? And chances are I probably said president. So you saying we need one opposition candidate is literally killing millions of dreams. You understand? Like I said, the moment we signed into multi-party politics, we forgot about individual people to lead and say it's NRM against Besigye, it's NRM against so and so. Right now, every individual in Uganda could step up and brace for being president. Of course, the finances might cut so many off, but everyone has a chance of being president. So what I think the opposition needs to do is to sit down and tell us what they want to do, like I said. But of course, notwithstanding the fact that the unity is important, I think years or 2 years ago, we had rangos in DP, we had rangos in FDC, we had every political party having rangos. It's thankful now that even though the rangos are there, the noise is not being heard. I think that's a step in the right direction. But to say that we are going to have one person representing the opposition, I think that is not true. And the other thing that you also need to note is that everyone is pointing and putting their eyes on Bobi Wine. But you need to put this in mind, that everyone going to war measures his ability to win the war. You understand? So this coalition might work for him when he realizes before nomination that he can't win. Because if he can't win, he also needs to sit down and say, okay, if I can't win this 2021 election, what's going to happen for me? Of course, he won't be in parliament, but he'll be in politics. So where will he be? You understand? Will he get a job somewhere out of Uganda? So, will he start being an activist like Besigye? What will he do? So this is sort of a cushion. It's subject, it's so achiwang. I can say, let me come here and put one political
person.
Yes. And of course, you also have to understand that there is no way Besigye is going to step aside. Yes. The purpose of the people's government is so that he can become Uganda's president. So for you to come and say, come into politics 1 year later and say, let you be the face of the opposition instead of undergrading him. So he's not going to step aside. So chances are that this coalition between Besigye and Bobi Wine is actually a cushion for Bobi Wine to step out of the presidential race, back into the parliamentary race, or into the mayor race. So for me, I think that's what the coalition
A couple of people on social media are saying that, you know, Besigye is giving kicks of a dying horse, that, you know, his career is probably lemming out, and that him getting together with Bobi Wine could be one of the reasons as to why he gets his career back. Do you think that's right, his political career that we're talking about? Would you agree with them on
that? Those are people with a Kampala mentality, that Uganda runs around Kampala. Uganda is way huger than Kampala. And for you to say that Bobi Wine's political career has for a short time become huger, very huge and huger than that of Besigye, I think is a lie. Besigye knows Uganda way better than Bobi Wine. Besigye has reached way more people than Bobi Wine has. Of course, we have to give Bobi Wine his respect, that he's reached a lot of people. His voice has been heard in a very short time, but he hasn't reached that level, basically, according to my own opinion.
Okay.
Besigye has traveled this country for 5 times, campaigning to be president. He has allies in places where Bobi Wine has probably never seen since he has, he came onto this earth. So I think for people who are coming out with that voice, I think some of them want to sort of throw stones at Besigye, just to water down his campaign and his dream. But I think that they are wrong in that regard. I think Besigye has seen Uganda more than Bobi Wine. He's had more people than Bobi Wine. And he still has the power. He still has the power.
Okay.
I think I would say Museveni, Besigye, and Bobi Wine.
Where is Edward Sekandi?
Edward Sekandi.
No Neda campaigner has, of course, did come up with a couple of demonstrations on the streets, whereby we did see people move out with saucepans and, of course, mingling sticks, all in the name of demonstrating the fact that they are not receiving enough food and they could probably die of hunger instead of COVID-19. Our team was on ground, and this is what they got from the streets. President, Disturbing moments of thought do run through my mind, especially when I look at these young, energetic men who are on the streets demonstrating for the fact that they're not receiving food from government, and at the end of the day, they could be dying of hunger. And instead of doing something about it to better themselves, they're getting onto the streets to demonstrate with saucepans. That makes sense to me at all, and it yields this particular question. Are the opposition people taking advantage over our vulnerable poor, like, you know, the government did call them when they were sending out this food in order for them to reach their goal? Head over to our social media pages and let me know what you think about that particular one. Coming back to you, Willis Daly, same conversation we were having yesterday. Young men being riled up, they're getting onto the street, they're, you know, fighting, they're demonstrating all in the name of, you know, not getting food from government. These young men should be out there trying to figure out how they survive during these tough times, but they're on the streets for this particular demonstration. I don't know. What's your take on it?
I think that the brains behind some of these things, are they hungry? No, they're not hungry.
Hungry for power, or
I think it's like they don't think through situations. How does a hungry person have energy to go on the streets and bang suspects? Like, you're dying of hunger, but you have energy to go and demonstrate. Even Jesus, when he was fasting for the 40 days, he went into a desert.
Yes.
You cannot have energy to demonstrate when you're hungry. I think that's a very wrong move in the opposition. I think that's it's the wrongest demonstration idea you can ever have. It's very wrong. As a young person, by the way, let me just draw for you a plan of a demonstration. There are people I will call the strikers. Those strikers are paid to demonstrate.
Okay.
The political actors pay the strikers to demonstrate. Those are strikers at demonstrations. They're not there to demonstrate. They are there to lead you into demonstration. They are the devil. They are leading you into temptation. So when you get arrested, those guys may not actually make it into prison because they have an exit plan from the demonstration. Second group of people who are in demonstrations, those are the people who Bambi innocently love the political actors. They bought into the story, and they sort of believe that these political actors are their gods. Whatever they say, they move. Even if the political actor tells you, sit there, the guy will sit. Come with me, the guy will move. You understand? They are there. Then three, they are idlers. People who have no place to stay, they have nothing to do, they are idle. Whatever comes, they go. You understand? Now, you as a hardworking young person who has a simple mobile money shop, if you're hungry at lunchtime, pray that God brings more customers. Work hard, reinvest your money, get something to do so that you get lunch to eat.
Do you think the opposition is taking advantage of these people?
I don't think there's such a thing as taking advantage of people. No, I don't think the opposition is taking advantage of anyone. These are adults, 18 and over, making their own decisions to join.
But they're being influenced to demonstrate. I mean, this is Bobby Wine, this is Dr. Kizza Best, just saying, you know what, guys, Encha, if you know you are not satisfied with what the government is giving you, quite a cephalia, quite a, you know, a mangling stick, to get again a street, to kubebu sepichi wafe. I mean, to me, that is someone influencing the demonstration.
Let me give you, it's probably taking advantage
of someone.
If there is a lion in the corner, and I come to you and tell you, Derek, there's a lion there, but it doesn't bite. Just go and say hello to it. Now, if you go and say hello to it and it bites you, am I to blame?
Probably. Because you have incited. I mean, that is why we talk about inciting of violence as well.
You are a grown-up Ugandan, 18 years and above. No one should be able to be... They were influenced and incited. How?
Willis, if I could take you back from, you know, what you just talked about. When you are giving us two groups of people that are in that particular demonstration, you talked about the strikers that usually are paid, they have a plan of exit. And you're talking about these other people people that usually do it for the love of the party. Mm. And, you know, they are coming through. And I also believe those are the same people that are coming through because they believe into what, you know, probably Bobi Wine or Besigye is telling them. They are being influenced. These are influential figures that we are talking about.
They influence not, someone's judgment. They are not being influenced. Mm. You see, when I come and tell you a very interesting story, and I tell you to join my party, it's upon you to think through it.
To join the demonstration. Because this particular round was not even talking about the party.
It was a demonstration. It is incumbent upon you, the individual, to think through, as a young person,
when these are young people who are easily brainwashed.
Easily?
Yes.
What do you mean easily?
I mean, that is how it has turned out to be.
I don't think it's easy. I don't think it's easy. Mm. Otherwise, Besigye would be president. I don't think it's easy.
I mean, if you were to look at the numbers there, I wouldn't say that it's the majority numbers. There are few numbers. That could be the same reason why Besigye has not made it to president.
I don't think it's easy. But for me, as a young person, I'll tell, as you know, for young people out there, let's not be used by politicians. You understand? Because these guys have their own intentions. And I'm saying this, whether it's the NRM or FDC or DP, everyone across the political space, let's not be used. Let's interrogate what these guys are doing, what they want us to do. Instead of telling me where you want Uganda to be and how you plan Uganda to be there, you're telling me to pull out a saucepan. Kati wankuba se pichi nenjime nyencha mfumbilewa. Ah, kale, mkute, I've got my saucepan, I've banked it. Government has heard that I'm hungry and now government wants to give me money. Where will I cook from? You understand? So these guys are not thinking through some of the things they're telling people to do. And I think it's very wrong. And this is where police comes and beats them up and they say, okay, beat them up. And clears the demonstration. And then they walk out, police say, Tukubi. I think it's very wrong where some of these guys are coming from with their ideas. I absolutely loved the conversation with Besigye and Bobi. I loved it. It showed unity, it showed peace, it showed progression. But when the first thing you do is to demonstrate with suspense, I think it's very wrong. I think they need to sit back and, you know, revise some of these things. Kwakati omuntu owaddala omufuna ngenjala emuluma and he gets energy and go kati gwenjala yokoma oyinza ogenda ku street
nenikenjala
ekumano n'onyiiga omwane kugenda mu nyindo n'otula ne weebaka
kati kwatwogere ku opposition unit ene egenda masa sawa zinotwogerera Bobi Wine and Besigye probably they're exchanging WhatsApp messages literally every hour, every minute, asking themselves, what is the next move, what should we do next? This unity among or between the two of them, do you think this is something that could go on even during the election time?
I don't think. I think it will be dropped. The biggest thing that the opposition faces right now is the idea of more. That's the biggest one of Chetiba Susatebe ever say. Mole. Who is a mole and where are the moles? That's the biggest conversation they have in the opposition. So this unity may not stand because of those things. People are going to start peddling around information. People, if I was in the leading party in NRM and wanted to remain in power, doing a coalition in the opposition is like handing me victory. Because I would sit and spend time to tear it apart. So that you'll spend time fighting to get it back together as I win the election. So I don't think it's going to stand even past the nomination stages, because that's where it will break. Because Besigye will say, I want to stand. We agreed on this, but we didn't say that who is going to stand. You understand? And how are they going to determine who is going to stand? Are they going to use the scientific method of people voting? Or are they going to decide and say, so what? How is it going to be? You understand? But also you have to think about other opposition political actors. Those guys who are in the opposition. You see, the opposition is just not about people wanting power. There are people who are in opposition because they just want a job. Like they want to oppose so that they earn. I don't know how they earn, but someone pays them. There are people who are in opposition and are in opposition to spy. For them, they are there to know.
They are spying for the incumbent.
Yes.
Okay.
There are people who are in opposition because they are idle. Umaze campus, toina chewe kole, deo notani kwa
ugana. Nogena mo opposition.
Hey, notani kwa ugana. Jerebali, you understand? So I think that to think that this is going to stand is to overestimate. It's overestimation of the opposition.
Last but not least, do you think the incumbent should be, you know, scared or threatened by this new unity between these two individuals?
No, he shouldn't be scared. He shouldn't be scared of the unity. Because it's going to be easy for him to tear it apart.
Okay.
What he should be scared of is if the media, the mass media, unfairly treat the opposition in terms of getting them space to campaign.
Okay.
That is going to be a very huge conversation.
Mm-hmm.
That if radio stations are denying the opposition a chance to campaign, that's going to show bad on the election. It's going to be bad for Ugandans, and I think people might even step out of the races.
Well, the electoral commission chairperson did come out to hint on that and said that they are going to be talking to the people in charge to make sure that there is free and fair time for the opposition as well as people in the incumbent government. Noneda is the name of this particular campaign that has been, of course, opened by Bobi Wine together with Dr. Kano Kizza Besigye, as far as you know, making sure that you people down there are able to receive the food that you need to receive from government. And in case you're hungry, you'd rather not die of hunger or even COVID, but rather seek out for government guidance. Right about now, we're going for a very short break, but when we do get back, Urban Today Weekend Edition still does get to continue. And on our third part, we shall be talking about education, saloons, and all that much more coming in.